I had my stomach pumped 2 times my senior year, which earned the approbation of all my plastered peers. Now I do my weekly bleeding at trendy AA meetings. I was a social monster, but now I serve my sponsor. I choke out cliche confessions. I suck down coffee black and I chain smoke cigarettes in between handfuls of Prozac. Man, in my one sober stallion, I just got my first medallion. My higher power drug me. I'm letting strangers hug me. And now I really crave a meeting. All those soothing empty greetings. The big book is omniscient, and I'm not self-sufficient. Changing drugs. Self-help study, 12-step program. Which hollow slogan was it? We find serenity in day by day, or easy does it? Plant that affirmation seed. Our license plate should read 10,000 lakes and treatment centers, ready for to statewide mentor. They say the devil's in the details of this cunning, baffling habit. I poured out all my NyQuil. I flushed my sonic tablets. Don't take others' inventory. Thanks for sharing your sick story. My bluff, I know they'll call it. I'm Stuart, I'm an alcoholic. Dysfunction breeds a strange sage, quoting pointless daily phrases. The big book is our mission, and I'm not self-sufficient.
I don't know why you even go to house parties. I mean, I can get drunk back in the apartment. I don't need to stand in line for a keg.
Yes, but like lemmings to the ocean, thus we return to the keg.
Why can't we be lemmings in the privacy of our own home?
You never see a lemming going off a cliff by himself. He's got to have somebody else's ass.
Well, Louie, you can be an ass at times. Why can't I get drunk with you in front of my face?
Back at the apartment, instead of in this stinky frat house.
As much of an ass as I could be, I can't quite compensate for the enormous asshole factory find the house party.
Why don't we throw our own party?
What for?
We've got a cool apartment.
It's too small.
We don't have to invite the whole campus. Come on, we can throw it next Friday night.
Don't you have your GREs next Saturday?
All the more reason to party Friday night.
I don't know.
Why not?
Raina's on break next week. He might come visit.
Raina, is that a...
high school sweetheart.
Oh, yeah.
And they still want each other.
We're just friends.
Yeah. That doesn't stop you from wanting a boner like a bonobo chip in heat, though, does it?
You know, Clay, I thought I might go for something a little more meaningful.
So you are sprung on the cat. All right, here's the deal. We throw the party for her, and you can put the moves on.
I never said I was going to put the moves on.
But if you were, a house party might be a safe place to do it, huh?
Huh? Huh?
Awesome.
Sweet.
You guys, before we break out the funny party hats, maybe we should talk to Sam.
Sammy.
Sammy.
No way.
Why not?
Because someone will pee on our bathroom floor.
Yeah, what else is new, huh?
And besides, it's sad seeing people get drunk and desperately grope for each other.
I think it's kind of funny. Come on, Sammy, you can invite Viv.
What's that supposed to mean?
Come on, you know you want her.
I do not want Viv. And I know Viv doesn't want me.
Oh, you'd be amazed at the kind of love connections that can be made at house parties. It's such a romantic setting.
Oh, please. House parties are like the mall. Except instead of shopping for clothes, we shop for other people.
Ooh, harsh.
No, think about it. We show up with our friends, walk around for a little while, and browse the merchandise, and if we go home with anything, it's usually something cheap.
Ooh.
Yes, Sammy, but this party's going to be different.
Oh, and who do you think you're going to invite?
Our friends.
Hardly any of our friends drink.
Ah, they do under the right circumstances. This will be the hugest fucking brain drain ever, man.
Hugest isn't a word, is...
I just don't want to be responsible when things get out of control.
I'll be responsible.
And when something gets broken?
If anything gets broken, I'll shave my head.
And when someone pukes on me?
If anybody pukes on you, I'll shave my ass.
Okay then, it's a deal.
Alright.
Hey Sammy, want me to puke on you?
Feel free.
Don't even think about it.
Hey, deal is sealed. You should think before you sacrifice your fate.
It don't matter, because everything is under control.
Orlando, Clay, what's up, man? How you doing? Thanks for vodka. So what do you think, man? This party look alright to you? Look promising?
Seems like it has potential.
Alright, man. Get it started. Light this party up and watch it burn, baby.
I'll see what I can do.
Hey! You guys ready to get crazy?
All right then. Forget about your homework.
No problem there.
Forget about that test. Shake that shit out of dog, cause we're going to places where none of that matters. You
I want to find something higher.
I want some ascendancy. I
mean, times, baby.
I want to get crazy.
Loopy. Snoopy. Juicy. I'm blind behind. Fucked up.
Free.
Boom. I'm ready. Let's do it.
Yo. Gotta get a cold beverage. I need some leverage. A sweaty ass as a lemon. It would be nice. Stop a fight from the top to a VK. Got a bar, got a drink. Fuck girls. Got the bait on the front porch. I got some ice tea. If you like a taste of tea, then come along with me. Summertime is steaming. Don't give me no bugs. Splash some ice and a dash of from the S Martini time. Yeah, yeah, feeling golden. Bring your own beverage. It's me, so it's cold. I like cold beverage, yeah. I like cold beverage, yeah. Give me a frosty mug filled with A&W. If you got ice cream to make it a double scoop, mistake from the vat and real good sounding. Chocolate egg cream, yo, orange and cherry grounding. Got a chill bar, Marshall's in my ride. While I was to the right, they got beverages inside of me. A hot coffee, then fill it up with ice. Watermelon, like it's rain. Please fix me a large slice. Summertime is cool, the heat is getting old. Yeah, I have a beverage, space, so it's cold. Cold, 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 cold.
Is something from the bar?
Yeah, I like cold beverage, yeah. I like cold beverage, yeah. I like cold beverage, yeah. Cause I'm feeling kinda buzzed. Stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge. Stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge. And a friend, go girl, work the cold one.
La cucaracha, la cucaracha. You guys have been under glasses.
You're not gonna drink that, are you?
Yeah, why?
I thought we agreed we weren't gonna drink together anymore.
What? We did. So don't drink.
It's my party, I'm gonna drink.
My beer. My beer. My beer. Ow!
Why don't you let me do the drinking for the both of us?
Usually do anyway.
Well, if that isn't the tampon calling the band-aid bloody.
Pete and Sammy are going to be watching you. Forget you drinking, smoking, or putting anything where it shouldn't be. You're going to be walking your butt home, okay?
Settle down. I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Besides, Mom would die if she even knew I was seeing this.
No. I would die if Mom knew you were seeing this. Now you go and have yourself an educational and mildly amusing time observing the party. Why didn't you tell me you were throwing a party?
I wanted to surprise you.
And my little brother?
You didn't tell me you were bringing Dan here.
He wanted to tour the campus, and I wanted to surprise you.
He should be okay as long as we can keep him away from Orlando. What's wrong?
That close to winning the lottery.
Chris, when are you going to quit playing that damn thing?
What do you have against the lottery?
Karl Marx said it all wrong. Religion isn't the opiate of the masses. The lottery is...
What are you talking about?
People are addicted to it.
It's their daily hit of hope.
What's wrong with hope? I mean, it's something valuable, something powerful.
No, no. If anything, it takes power away. Instead of going out and doing something to improve your life, you pour your cash down into some impossible gamble that never pays off. For God's sakes,
have a little faith in yourself.
You're right. I mean, I've seen the light. I should live a dreary, hopeless life and never even consider the fact that something better could happen tomorrow.
Thank you. I feel so much more powerful.
I don't understand those old TV westerns. Have you seen these? I mean, the bad guys rob the bank and then take off, right? And the good guys get together and say, well, we better head them off at the pass. And they would always catch them. See, what I want to know is, if there's a shortcut to the pass, why do the bad guys take it to begin with? I mean, what do they do? Rob the bank and then say, well, that went pretty well. Why don't we take the scenic route out of town? It doesn't make any sense.
You're so funny. You know. If you and Heather ever break up, you gotta give me a call.
Actually, Heather and I broke up last week.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Louie. What happened?
She told me that the time she was spending with me was detracting from the time she usually spent with God, and that it was damaging her relationship with
him. So you basically get dumped for God?
Yeah. You know, I should have figured out there was something going on between two of them because every time we had sex, she would always scream his name.
Anyway, I never saw you two as a couple. She's too, perky for you.
I like happy people. Why does everybody think I'm this cynic who's mad at the world?
Probably because you shamelessly rip apart everyone's beliefs.
Yeah, but I do the ripping so cheerfully.
Right. So, you're single, huh?
Last time I counted, there was only one of me.
So now that you're single, are you finally gonna ask me out on a date?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't like you.
Thanks. That was so inconsiderate.
What? Should I lead her on? She keeps hitting on me and I'm not attracted to her. She needs to wake up and smell the rejection.
A lot of people aren't ready to wake up.
And a lot of people are asleep at the wheel and about to go into the ditch.
Maybe you should try accepting people rather than destroying them. You could try to be a little more understanding.
I understand people too well. They make me sick.
Kindness, Louie. Kindness.
Mary, you're a saint, which is something I greatly admire, but I never want to be. Saints have to put up with a lot of crap.
Hey, I'm pretty happy with my life.
Which is why you're so great. You don't lie like all these other people do. You look at the world straight with an ugly face, just smile.
Tonight, aren't we?
You want to talk to him?
How come?
I don't know, I'm shy, I guess.
You're more than shy. You're mine. Yeah, I never see you talking. What's the deal?
Well,
connect. When I talk to people, I just don't feel like I connect with them. We have nothing in common. At least, nothing significant.
You've never been inebriated, have you?
No, I don't think it would do much for me.
That's your problem. You need to share in the universal communion. Liquor leads to a wonderful commonality. Let me help you. You'll come to a diffused clarity of mind.
I don't know. People seem so fake when they're drunk. Do you really think it would help?
Is the Pope Italian?
I don't know.
Doesn't matter. I promise that if you imbibe, you will connect.
Yeah. What the heck? I suppose it's worth a try.
This is my blood given to you. Drink this for the resemblance.
I went to Bloomington, Jefferson.
You did not! Excuse me! Has anybody asked for this?
Did you know?
I didn't ask.
You found this?
Yeah.
Is anybody?
So how's your family? You did a lot.
Hey, Vivs! Vivs! Hey, how's it going? Hey, you know, I was wondering, do you have any journey?
Not that I know of.
You want some?
Sorry, Marty, I'm not attracted to you.
What? How can you not be attracted to me?
I'm just not attracted to guys anymore.
Oh, I see. Actually, I don't blame you. If I was a woman, I wouldn't be attracted to guys either. But that's okay. Recognize one of them. We can go have some fun.
I never said I was attracted to women either.
So you're, waiting. I'm confused.
Well, I'd rather be in a relationship with a woman than a man, but I'm not planning on getting intimate with either.
Hey, Tony, I haven't seen you around.
I'm self-sexual.
Self-sexual? You get off on yourself?
Oh, yeah, don't you?
No. If I did, it wouldn't be by choice. We had a 5-on-1 date.
That's too bad because I find it really satisfying.
Come on, Viv, you know you want it.
No, Marty.
You want me to give it to you, too?
I can give it to myself, thanks anyway.
Oh, could you give it to me then?
Marty, you can give me anything worth it in return.
Lots has been to give and to receive.
Then why don't you go give it to yourself?
No way. I'm just gonna have to go squawk some clothes.
Oh my god! Look at you.
Oh, I was an ugly kid.
No.
So, do you miss high school?
I miss the free time I had in high school. The time we had together. How about you?
I miss it a lot. I miss being in a relationship.
So why aren't you? Sammy told me you have girls beating down your door. Are you playing hard to get?
I don't have time for girls. I'm not playing hard to get. I am hard to get.
Oh, really? You have better things to do, huh?
To be blunt? Yeah. What can I say? I'm in college and my priorities are screwed up.
Oh. I'm sorry to hear I'm no longer a priority.
Hey, no, I didn't say that. I said the girls are a priority. You're a woman.
Oh. So if I went here, would you drop your homework and spend all your free time with me?
I'm afraid so. You'd ruin the few hopes of a career I still cling to.
Well, we wouldn't want that to happen, would we?
I don't know. It wouldn't be so bad.
Oh, that's a pretty good job.
Yo, all the rules, right?
There are no rules. This is cutthroat chicken fighting. First one to four loses. And fight!
Get them down from there.
Wow.
Because someone's gonna break their neck and I'm gonna get sued.
Dude, sure. Nothing bad is gonna happen. I've got this party under control.
Why don't you control it down to a nice, quiet, meditative state?
Oh, Sammy, this is not a yoga class. This is a party. You want peace and quiet? Huh? You want peace and quiet? Go build yourself an igloo and live in it. Hey! No kissing! You guys are supposed to be trying to hurt each other.
That comes later on in the relationship.
So what do you have planned now when you graduate?
After I graduate, my job future is looking about as good as Mark Hamill's.
Who?
Exactly. Nobody even remembers the guy. He got one lucky job. Since then, he hasn't done squat.
I don't know who you're talking about, but you shouldn't be worried about your job future. You've worked hard, you'll get what you deserve.
I don't know. You see so many people who work hard and don't.
What do you mean? Eventually everybody gets what they deserve. Look at yourself. You succeeded so far.
Yeah, but it's because I've had parents that have supported me. I've gone to a good school. My teachers have expected me to do well. Everything you say I deserve, I actually have been given. I mean, I haven't had to work nearly as hard as, say, Haitian boat refugee.
Yeah, but if those people want to succeed, they could. There's nothing stopping them except a little effort.
And people like you won't give them a chance.
Hey, if I'm running a business, I'm doing it to make a living. I'm going to hire the people I know who can get the job done. I'm not going to hire the people who could do the job if only they hadn't eaten paint chips as a kid. I want a skilled person who can do the job, and face it, honey, that's you.
But if I'm skilled because of my luck, and my luck runs out, how do I know I won't end up like Mark Hamill?
Who the hell is Mark Hamill?
He played Luke Skywalker in the Star Wars movies.
What the hell ever happened to that guy?
That's just it. Who knows? I mean, in the early 80s, he was on top of the world. But when the Star Wars dice stopped rolling his way, he crapped out. You know, you ask me, drunk smart people act a lot dumber than drunk dumb people.
No, drunk dumb people still act dumber.
But drunk dumb people keep their mouths shut. Drunk smart people ramble on and on about all their inner self conflicts and the meaninglessness of life. Alcohol in smart people leads to a lot of verbal and mental masturbation.
Dumb people do that too. They just use smaller words.
So, are you a freshman?
No.
Really? Wow, you look so young.
That's just my baby face. I have the body of a man, I see.
Wow, you are ripped. I'm surprised you don't have a girlfriend.
So am I.
Well, you can give me a call. We can go out sometime.
Sure. Sounds great.
Great!
Hey, watch it!
Oops, sorry.
Oh, God.
I guess this drink's on you.
My sister's gonna kill me. She's gonna smell the alcohol on me and think I've been drinking.
Your sister? I grant you forgiveness in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, whatever.
You! You look dangerously drunk, my friend.
Yeah.
Yes, I am. Listen, you need to stop drinking and let me take care of the mini cake.
But it wants me to take care of it. I'm like the Mary Poppins of mini cakes.
Okay, let's make a deal. If you can go without puking in the next, say, 60 seconds, you can drink all you want. If you can't, I get to keep it for myself.
Deal? Let's make a deal.
Pickle, tickle! Pickle?
Pickle? Wait a... Hold on!
Well, I guess my business is done here.
Man, you're puking in the dryer.
What the hell happened to you?
Some hussy spilled her drink all over my shirt.
I don't know. Oh, I better go.
This hussy, did she have short brown hair?
Yeah. Why?
That hussy's my girlfriend.
I meant hustle in a good way.
See you later, Frank.
Oh. Hey, where are you going?
I'm gonna go watch the Wolves game.
Why? They're gonna lose.
Maybe they are, but that doesn't mean I shouldn't watch them.
So, you enjoy watching losers.
It's better than watching teams that win all the time. Why watch the Bulls? You know they're gonna win. I mean, there's no suspense. There's no hope for anything better. The Wolves are the complete opposite. They may not be great, but they could win any night.
But chances are they're still gonna lose.
What's victory without defeat? I mean, okay, if you have candy for every meal. It's not candy anymore. It's just, ew. A win for the Wolves has greatness because of the defeat.
But after 8 years of losing, aren't you a little tired?
No, I feel that much more powerful. I mean, a faith that isn't tested is weak. Mine is battle-worn, and I'm that much stronger because of it.
You are wacko because of it.
Whatever. What are you doing with that mini keg anyway?
I'm gonna keep it in the bathroom until the party's ready for it.
Okay. Later.
Yeah, see ya.
Why don't people keep that to themselves? I don't want to see it.
You'd pay $5 to go to the theater and see the same thing. You should be happy you're getting that for free.
I do not see that at a movie theater. And besides, I don't go to movies full of sex.
That doesn't leave much else.
I like love stories, not smut.
Love stories? You want to hear a real love story?
Okay.
All right, here goes. There was once this peasant boy who loved a maiden so much that if he couldn't have her, his heart would burst.
What happened?
He couldn't have her. His heart burst and he died.
Jerk.
Look, you've got to wake up and smell reality, okay? Look, what's your favorite movie?
Peter Pan.
Peter Pan?
Yeah, it's sweet.
Sweet? It's a huge endorsement of the drug culture. And Peter is obviously a small-town dealer who talks Wendy and the boys into trying some pixie dust, which blatantly refers to angel dust. And once the kids take it, they fly off to this magical world of Never Never Land, which is just a state of drug-induced delusions. And then Hook is obviously a pimp. Think about it, he's got the hat with the big feather coming out of it and the big frilly clothes and the platform shoes.
Oh, yeah.
That's because he's a pirate.
No, it's because he's a pimp. Think about it. Why does he want Wendy to join his crew? It's so he can pimp her, man. He wants Wendy to become a hooker. And see, then Peter is moving in on the Hook's turf, and that's why they have it out.
Disney isn't like that. You're full of bullshit.
Bullshit? Well, it's not very Disney of you.
Shut up.
Why don't you go ahead and live in your own little world, Never Never Land?
I hope you didn't scar her.
I need to do more than scar her. her belief in a full body amputation.
Peapod?
I suppose so.
So why are you in here drinking it by yourself?
It's my responsibility to drink it for the rest of you.
Excuse me?
First of all, you people couldn't handle it. You'd end up walking around saying how much you love each other.
So you steal our beer?
Don't think of it as I'm stealing your beer. I'm merely a strong individual who knows what he wants and has willed himself to it. There's nothing wrong with that.
I don't follow.
Jeff. I see we have a long ways still to go with you.
You guys seen Aspen?
That one. Those things go with Pete.
Yeah, how's Pete?
Fine.
Oh. How's communication going? You haven't seen each other for a while, so just wondering how.
Am I missing something here? Because I really feel like I am. Just wondering. You can just ask me straight out if we're going to sleep together.
I'm offended. How about you, Clay? Because that is not at all
really
what
offended.
You want.
I wasn't
I'm
going
sorry.
For that at all. Just a good thing to know, though. Did you go to the store, man?
Well, I'm actually looking for Vaseline now. Do you have any Vaseline? You know, I just heard the other day that Vaseline, the guy that discovered Vaseline, he ate a spoonful of this stuff every day.
Yeah, but
he did. He lived till he was like 98 years old. Vaseline was first marketed as like jelly, and like put on toast and stuff. It was flavored like with strawberries and cherries and stuff. People ate Vaseline. It's a petroleum product. Well, I'm gonna try some. You know? I'll see you later.
Yeah. He's just drinking beer, right? That's all I wanna know. I wanna know it's only, it's beer, only beer in the apartment.
Okay, let's pretend that humanity has found that this planet out in space that's uninhabited has abundant natural resources that we can really use back here on Earth. But there's one problem. We have no way to get there. So, almost everyone says, aw shucks, and sits on their little pretty asses. But there was one lady who decided to dedicate her whole life to finding a way to get there. After spending decades of hard work, she creates a spaceship and flies it to this planet, which she then claims as her own, hoping to sell the natural resources that she mines there back on Earth. But when she returns to Earth, her goods and technology are confiscated by the governments of the world for the common good of humanity, and she's given no reimbursement. Those who did nothing are rewarded for her hard work. Do you follow me so far?
Yeah, I guess.
That is how modern society works. Those that are intelligent, the skilled, they're punished for their ability. The powerless and the unskilled are rewarded for their own incompetence. It is a complete and total reversal of Darwin's survival of the fittest. The weak have subverted the power from the strong, and in doing so, have stunted the will of the skilled to work hard and advance our society.
Okay, but what does this have to do with you hogging the mini cake?
I'm the powerful. I saw what I wanted. I took it. I willed it to me. I had the skill. I had the intelligence. I decided to make it mine, and it's mine by right.
But you didn't even work for the mini cake. You just stole it.
All property is theft. The only difference between me and everyone else is that I don't pretend to follow some objective moral law. I make my own moral universe. I am my own god.
Yeah, you're a god.
Yeah, when I want to be.
How much of the mini cake have you had?
Not enough.
I gotta go! Let me in!
Hey, what's wrong?
Pete, help me out here! The door's locked, I've been like waiting in line for 10 minutes.
Come on, open up, we got an emergency out here, come on!
Hey guys, what's going on here?
Just gotta go to the bathroom.
I gotta go.
Just chill, alright? Check this out, let's put some rhythm to this.
What?
You ready? Alright. Yella, yella, man. Oh, yeah, boy, yeah. Yella, yell, big man, big man. Yella, yella. Oh, yeah, boy, yeah. Yella, yell, big man, big man. You hear this? Yella, yell, big man. What's that? Yella, yell, big man.
Hey,
that's
why I'm dying. Guys, quiet down in here.
What's wrong? What's
here? Look, the neighbors just called. They said it's so loud they can't eat.
Oh, the neighbors.
Well, quiet. So keep down a little bit. Well, thanks quiet. A lot, guys.
It's good.
Sorry.
No great advance has ever come from the herd mentality. The herd is weak. I'm the individual. I'm strong.
Oh, come on. What about when the herd tramples the individual to death? Who's the strong then?
You call that strength? That is the weakest thing in the world.
No, it's not. The people have all the power in this world. The majority rules.
The majority are ruled by individuals. They are the strong. Now.
You're the weak, and I'm the strong. Admit it. You're the weak. You're the weak. Admit it.
Okay, all right, I'm the weak. Settle down.
But you want to be strong, don't you?
Yeah, I suppose.
You can't suppose. You have to be certain. You have to assert yourself. You have to know what you want, you have to know what you believe, and then you have to go after it. Now, what do you want?
I want the rest of the mini cake.
Give it back.
No.
Give it back.
No. See, I will myself to it. It's mine now.
Only the strong are able to share. You want to be strong, don't you?
Not anymore.
Listen here, punk. You give me that mini keg, or I am going to kick your ass so hard,
you're going to need an air respirator.
Yeah, go ahead and try. God, you're drunk.
I'll be back. Stay here.
I'm not going anywhere with my mini pig.
Go, 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 go,
go, hey, you guys missing a mini pig?
Yeah, what the hell is it?
Where's the mini pig?
I found some guy hiding in the bathroom.
Where's the mini pig?
Hogging it all to mice. I mean, himself. He must have stole it. We should kick his ass.
Kick his ass.
Yeah.
No. Violence is so unattractive. Let's be more creative than that. Let's be art.
Tape him up. Tape him up. Tape him up. He's a bad drunk. Bad, bad, bad drunk.
But I'm telling you, it wasn't me. I didn't take it. It was
Fred! We caught you red-handed. You've been a bad drunk, now shut up! And pay your penance.
Don't feel bad, Jeff. I think you're a work of art. Like a Monet.
That is just the alcohol blurring your vision.
Neat effect.
What the hell is going on here?
Oh, just
you're gonna ruin the wall.
Relax, will you? Just go have a beer or something.
Fine, Cliff. Trash the apartment. I don't care anymore. But remember, it's your ass that's gonna pay for it.
Hey, man, my ass is ready to cash any check that this party writes.
Yeah. Well, Jack, looks like people do get what they deserve.
What are you doing up here? Give it, give it me!
You see all these people here? You think they could all just come together and groove like this? Nah, the wheels need to be oiled. After a few drinks, there's no ice to be broken. Everybody starts falling through.
I was homeless. I had to drive by North Park. Yeah, that one with the covered slide, the long orange tube. Anyways, these kids were going down. They were just firing down there one after another. started thinking back to, you know, that time when it was like our third time and everybody told us how great it was on the covered slide. On the covered slide in the park. And then, you know, I went to bed that night and all I could see was the kids coming down on top of us. And you with your pants down and we pushing us together. And all I could think of, you know, when I woke up and cleaned myself up, all I could think of in the morning was how happy I was that I was dating you, because any other girl, I mean, up to that point, I dated just dances and ugly. Oh, well, anyways. Who else up until then could have come up with the whole the science experiments?
I know, and they're probably like, oh, right.
Yeah, going home to get the permission slips from their mom.
Ah, me, daddy, we're people.
Wasn't that great?
Yeah, it was.
Do you want to do it again?
Do you have any Vaseline?
Well, yeah, back at my place, but not here.
Zed? Shoot, I've got to find some. You want to give me a hand?
Sure, I'll give you a hand.
Hey, who's the strong now? Huh? Who's the strong? Yeah? Anyone?
Hey, Gracie, how you doing? Hey, are you and Clay still going out?
Yes, Marty.
Why?
Probably because we love each other.
Oh, jeez.
Love, Schmuck. You know, you deserve better.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you're a special girl. You deserve to be treated like a queen.
Marty, I know you're only saying that because you want to sleep with me, but I still really appreciate it.
You know, I should really appreciate it. You drop the zero and get it figured out.
You're 8 inches
ahead. She already gets that from me, Marty.
Cool. How you doing?
Not bad.
Marty thinks that I should dump you.
Yeah, so I heard.
Hey, I was just...
What do you think about that?
What do you think about
it?
This is what I think about it. Marty, why don't you make like a goal and get the puck out of here?
All right. I'll see you around, Clay.
Sorry to hear about you and Heather.
Oh, it's no big deal.
Well, I thought you were in love with her.
Are you kidding? I didn't love her. I don't even believe in love.
Louie.
I just don't think that when somebody says they love somebody else, that they're feeling this totally selfless giving emotion. As the great John Lennon said, love is needing to be loved. It's a selfish thing.
Lennon also said love is a lot of other things as well. Love is feeling and caring.
But if you care for somebody, you should say, I care for you, not I love you.
Well, just because love is hard to define doesn't mean love doesn't exist.
No, it's hard to define because it doesn't exist. Nobody has any idea what they're talking about. Okay. Do you remember your first boyfriend?
Marty Moms.
And I'll bet you wrote, I love Marty forever on your hand and all your notebooks. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, it was junior high.
And do you still love Marty?
Well, things have changed, but sure, I still love Marty.
Oh, I love you too, Viv. Does this mean we're gonna do it?
No, Marty.
If you really love me, you'd have sex with me. See what I mean? People even use the word to get sex.
No, not people. Guys use love to get sex. Girls use sex to get love.
Hey, I don't use love to get sex. I use charm.
No, Marty. You just use.
Everybody uses. You think love is selfless? You love somebody because it gives you something. Self-esteem. Understanding. Loss of guilt. Sex. Money. Come back to my place and I'll give you something to never forget.
What? A disease?
That's not a very loving thing to say, Viv.
Well, as soon as Marty figures out that love isn't just a verb, I'll love Marty.
So give him some constructive criticism instead of just ripping him a new orifice.
Constructive criticism. Look who's talking.
I'm allowed to criticize. I don't pretend to love people.
Hey, Viv, if I pretend to love you, would you go home with me then?
No, Marty.
Come on. Your legs are like butter and I'm ready to spread.
I feel so sorry for you.
Even I have more tact than that, Marty. She's like a nun or something.
No, but she reminds me of something.
I think it's my mom.
So you got one of those, what do you call them? Sisyphus complexes.
Oedipus complex, maybe.
Whatever. It's all Greek to me.
Well, you gotta dribble before you shoot
those. Neat picture. Your sister's gonna kill you. Come on.
You know, Pete, I'm afraid your love life isn't gonna get a lot better after college. I mean, you're gonna go from the dead college scene to the slimy bar scene.
Oh, I know. I've actually tried the bar scene. I was an absolute failure.
No. You probably have some better pickup lines.
Actually, I've got one. You wanna hear
it? Sure.
Okay, here it goes. Hi there. Can I buy you a drink? Or do you just want the money?
I missed you. I almost regret breaking up with you.
Well, you could always correct that mistake.
It was a mistake, you creep.
Wow. Still sense some hostility. I thought you had forgiven me.
I have.
Then why did you call me a creep?
Creeping back in my heart, it's pissing me off.
Do you want to go someplace we can talk?
Talk, huh? You sure you're not going to push me in a corner and try and seduce me?
No. I just think we need to talk.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah! Boom!
I just want to show you something.
Sammy! What are you doing?
Andy, are you drunk?
Yeah, can you believe it? Zed talked me into it. It's an experiment in communication. I'm trying to drink my way past the barriers of inhibition. So let me in.
Yeah, why don't we say things we really don't mean and won't repeat when we're sober?
No, don't say that. When I say I love you, I really mean I love you. And right now, I love you!
Yes, but will you still love me in the morning?
Sure, if you want me to.
Andy, let's bust the groove. What I so fucking love, my needs, you got a problem, baby. Is a stop, so for me, did you make it today? Was I always stop by if you like me to? Yeah, I'll do anything that you could ever want for me to. So a kiss for summer, this is smile, it's darkness. I'm your mister, my sister, your sister. My mother, your mother, father, your father. It all started when I kissed her. I missed her, dig.
Weird party, man.
What's your problem?
I didn't appreciate all the public striptease.
What's wrong with me dancing in my boxers?
Nothing. If you want to make a fool out of yourself, then...
A fool? What's the difference between me dancing in my boxers and wearing swimming trunks to the beach?
There's a difference.
Oh, yeah, right. The beach is a public place. This is my apartment. At the beach, I'm surrounded by complete strangers. Here, I'm surrounded by my friends.
If anything, I should wear some skimpy clothing to the beach.
How would you like it if I stripped down to my underwear and started dancing around in front of everyone?
It's different. You're a girl.
Whoa. I hope Sammy doesn't see this.
What was that about? I don't know, man. Sometimes I don't understand that girl.
Everyone does.
But don't some people have to bust their asses working for small rewards, and others are given everything by pure luck?
But you can't get another one.
No, I think good things happen to good people. We're looked out for.
By who?
God.
But isn't God supposed to be all-loving? If he is, then why did he stack the game so that one team ends up having to work twice as hard and usually loses anyway?
I don't know. I'm sure things happen for a reason. God put everyone here for a purpose.
So he purposely placed someone into a world where they're destined to die of starvation by age 5. And someone else is put here where they don't have to work a day in their life and not know pain?
I don't think God has that much control.
But you just said you placed everyone here for a purpose. That sounds like an awfully lot of control to me.
You don't understand. God... God is so far above us. So much more intelligent and understanding than any person. You just have to believe that everything has its point.
So I should have faith that for some reason, God likes me better than everybody else, and that I deserve everything that I've been given.
Doesn't that make God biased? I don't know. Don't worry about it. Everything will be clear when we get to heaven.
Me? Are you sure I'm going? Right now, my future does not look bad.
Grace, I hate to be the one to tell you this, but you are not the world's best drunk.
Even if Clay was being stupid, he probably shouldn't have slapped him.
I know I shouldn't have. I don't even know if he loves me.
I don't know if Clay is capable of it.
There's one way to find out. He loves me? He loves me, Snot. He loves me? He loves me, Snot.
The fact that you're plastered makes that no less disgusting. And you may think it's love, but it's not.
Clay to love me again.
Let's see. How do you make someone think they're in love? Sex usually helps.
Not when he's drunk. He'll be flying the flag at half mast.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, then, you'll just have to sober him up.
Okay.
Grace. I was just kidding. Grace?
See, I got a problem with chick slapping guy. I know a lot of girls can kick my ass, and they can pummel me to death, and that's okay. But if I hit back, I'm a woman beater. You should be thrown in jail. Man, screw chivalry. There shouldn't be a double standard when it comes to physical abuse. If a chick hits me, she's gonna get the smack put down her ass.
You shouldn't call them chicks, man. It's not politically correct.
Oh, yes, it is. It's chick with a Y.
Stop drinking. You don't love me when you're drunk.
I don't love you when you slap me. Now give me my beer back.
Not until you tell me you still love me.
Do you honestly think that taking my beer away from me is gonna make me love you?
Sam is a little
drunk. Listening to Sammy. Give me my beer back.
No!
Give me.
No!
Ah! Oh, you're caught, man.
Fuck! Get away!
I need to get this cleaned up. Come on. I'll take care of it.
Need another beer.
Well, that's something to kill the momentum. Okay, forget about that. Let's put this party in overdrive. Let's bring out the terror.
Yeah.
It's time for the Monster Truck Contest. Power, power, power.
Watch as the Lord jump on the river. I'm coming like nothing you've seen before.
I'm round
the 4x4s.
Grace, you're gonna freeze to death!
I don't care!
Grace!
Grace, you cannot let him do this to you! Clay does stupid things. It's a part of who he is.
I know it is, but why do I have to be a part of it?
Well, you wouldn't be if you weren't his girlfriend.
I want to be his girlfriend.
Why?
Because I love him!
But do you have to be his girlfriend in order to love him?
It sure helps.
But if you gave that up, you wouldn't have all this pain.
And I wouldn't have him!
But you would have your freedom. Clay wouldn't be controlling how you felt from one minute to the next.
And you could still be good friends with him.
Oh, that's funny. Still be friends? Oh, that's just rich. I know you think Clay is bad for me because we argue and I always get upset, but you don't understand. Clay needs me. He's going through a lot of stuff right now. And he loves me.
Does he?
Here you go.
Thanks.
My pleasure. Now you better sleep this off, huh?
Don't want to sleep. Want to party. I get right here. Why don't you come join me?
No, Clay, you have a girlfriend.
Are you sure about that? What the fuck are you doing? Get out of here.
I don't have to get here. It's my bedroom. Look, your girlfriend's outside crying in the snow and you're in here kissing Nina? What the fuck is wrong with you, Clay?
I don't need this shit. Ugh.
Don't you realize Clay has a girlfriend, or doesn't it make any difference to you?
Look, I was trying to tuck him into bed. He pulled me down and her lips accidentally bumped.
Accidentally bumped? Give me a break.
Well, he kissed me, but I resisted. Then he kissed me again. And then you walked in.
You expect me to believe that? You've thrown yourself at every single guy at this party. Don't you realize how ugly desperation is?
I am not desperate.
It sure looks that way to me. I see you.
No, you don't see me, Louie. You don't. Yeah, it's real easy to criticize somebody. You're real good at that. But you've never even taken the time to get to know me. It's a lot harder to accept and understand somebody, isn't it? Go ahead and judge me and call me desperate. I just want someone to love me. I don't think that's so wrong.
bathtub. Worry about any shithead to get me out of here. Box in the freezer, I damn, girlfriend. Dog is naked in my own house whenever I want to, damn it.
So, what's this about me creeping back into your heart?
I knew I shouldn't have said.
I'm just curious.
I know you, Pete. I can smell the seduction on your breath.
What are you talking about?
I've been extremely flirtatious.
So have you.
So maybe you should speak up.
Maybe I have, but we're not talking about me.
Well, let's talk about you. Why have you been flirtatious?
Next question.
Come on.
I don't want to tell you because I think you'll take it.
Tell me.
You'll go psycho on me.
Well, if you think I'll go psycho on you, I can pretty much guess what it is you're hiding from me.
Oh, you can! Wow! Please fill me in!
Okay. This is just my theory. It's not based on empirical evidence, so take it as you will.
Let me have it.
Here it goes. I think that you're falling back in love with me.
Really? That's an interesting theory you have there.
Well, are you?
Even if I was, I wouldn't tell you.
Well, you're not telling me. So, does that mean you are?
I'm not telling you.
Ah, but by not telling me, you're telling me.
You say so.
This is how Lawrence Rock felt on a bad day. Consumed by the bubbles.
Go away! Go away!
Fucking maid service.
As soon as Sammy stops bad-mouthing Clay.
Grace, I've said it a million times and I'll say it again. I like you. I like Clay. But I don't like you and Clay together. You hurt each other and give everybody around you a big headache.
You'd be happy if we broke up.
Happy probably isn't the best word, but...
Well, what about my happiness? You know, Sammy, not everyone is like you. We don't all have the patience to hold out for the perfect mate. The rest of us have learned to find happiness where we can get it, even if that means taking some pain, too.
Grace, I realize you love Clay, and that's great, but there comes a point where love just turns into losing yourself in the other person, where you sacrifice yourself at their altar.
Clay loves me, which is something you'd obviously not know about.
Grace!
It is times like these that I am glad I am single.
Yeah, I guess we're two of the lucky few who don't mind being single.
Oh, I mind it. It's just that I'm not gonna lower my standards so I won't be alone. I don't know how you can totally swear off relationships, though.
Believe me, I'm not giving up that much.
What? A bad track record, or...?
Well, that's part of it, but the main reason is that I'm just really happy being by myself. I don't feel like I need to date someone in order to feel love. I get plenty from my friends and family.
What about the passion factor? Don't you ever miss out on being in love?
Well, I am in love. I'm in love with the world, my life, the people in it. I make love every day.
Really? Jeez. Here this whole time you've been making love to me and I didn't even realize it.
You didn't? Boy, I must be a pretty bad lover.
No, you just settled.
So, Where are you from, anyway?
Alaska.
Wow, really?
Yeah, you want to touch me?
I'm
just kidding. It's just that whenever I tell anybody I'm from Alaska, they always say, wow, really? As if I was some exotic bird or had done something spectacular. It's just a state.
Sorry.
Don't be. I'm sorry about that thing with Clay.
Hey, it's okay. We all make lapses in judgment.
Yeah. I guess I've just been feeling really lonely lately.
How come?
Well, it's senior year. I always thought I was gonna meet the man I was gonna marry in college.
Who says you have to meet your future spouse while you're in college? There's a lot of people out in the real world.
Yes, but after freshman year in college, there's a 75% chance that you've already met your future spouse.
75%?
The odds only get worse as I get older.
Well, you could be part of the minority.
Yeah, I could also be part of the minority that never gets married.
Don't be so pessimistic.
I'm gonna die alone in a month.
Nina, what about your friends and family?
I'm an only child. My parents will be dead before me, and my friends will be scattered. Who else is there?
You'll find someone. Heck, you're growing on me.
Uh-huh.
You are. I'm sorry I was such a jerk to you in the past.
You just didn't realize what an intelligent, sensitive woman I was.
You're right.
I was joking.
I'm serious. I really didn't know you. I probably still don't.
Well, here I am.
But I still think a B-plus was a bit extreme. Maybe in your opinion, Professor. I gotta go. Physics.
Have you seen Clay?
Hey, Clay is history. I'm the future, baby.
Marty, you've been hitting on everybody at this party but me. Am I ugly?
You're virgin drunk. It's not cool.
Marty, I'm surprised.
Hey, I do have morals. Fuck me if I'm wrong, but isn't your name Sweet Tits?
If I were you, I'd learn to masturbate.
Marty, did you really think she would talk to you if you said that?
Hey, I get lucky every now and then.
But you're so obvious. You might as well say, what the fuck?
I've tried that one before. It doesn't work as well. 9 times out of 10, I get slapped. That 10th time.
So you take these girls back to your room, have sex with them, and that's it?
Yep.
And what do you get from this?
It sucks. It feels great.
But don't you want something more? Wouldn't it be better if you had sex with someone you loved?
I wouldn't know.
Would you ever even talk to the girls? Get to know them?
I can't talk to chicks too long. No, wait. There's this gap.
And you fill the gap with your penis?
Correct the mundo.
It's just like humanity. We can't communicate, so we fuck each other.
He must have passed out.
Let's just break the door down.
Clay, please open up. Is Clay in here?
Yeah, we think so. He's been locked in there for the last 5 minutes.
Clay? Go pee outside. I have to take care of Clay. Clay, wake up.
Hey, Two-Face?
Yeah.
I'm really cold.
Don't worry, I'll take care of you.
You know what, Viv? The thing I like about you is that you know how to love without wanting to own.
Yeah, too many people grow to love something and then just crush it. Like,
Lenny's squeezing the rabbit.
Yeah, yeah. Can I pick the rabbit's throat? Pretty rabbit. Man, I'm sorry. I just don't like being squeezed. I mean, I'm not a roll of Charmin. You know, I always felt bad for Mr. Whipple. I mean, just leave the poor guy's toilet paper alone. Too many people try to impose their lives on others. Like this damn party. I've lost the ability to live my life as I please.
Sammy, you're a control freak.
I am. I admit it. But I don't think that's necessarily bad. I mean, people should have control over their own lives. You know, this all reminds me of this old AA prayer that my parents had hanging over their bed when I was a kid.
How fitting an AA prayer at a house party.
How did it go? God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the power to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. I guess I just need a little more serenity.
No, I think you're fine just the way you are.
Yeah. Yeah, I am.
You know, coffee shops are going to begin selling methamphetamines.
So did you hear Alan and Julia are engaged?
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez, everyone's getting married.
Yeah, they're dropping like flies.
Yeah, of course flies are attracted to shit.
What does that mean? Don't you think Alan and Julia are right for each other?
Oh, I'm not saying that. I just think that people see this big question mark in their future, and so they jump at the first security blanket they find.
Well, not everyone is like that.
No, of course not. I just think the couple should realize that if they're meant to spend the rest of their lives together, it's gonna happen.
Are you trying to tell me you never worry about being alone?
I have faith that eventually something will happen.
What do you think? Can I sign you up? I'm also an agent.
I probably shouldn't be doing this while I'm drunk. I'm liable to poke my brain out.
But it feels so good. It is just like sex.
Huh?
Well, think about it. You take this long, phallic-looking device, you stick it into a... never mind. I won't even go there.
Come on, don't hide from me. I want to know all about you. And if a Q-tip sex fetish is part of that, then let me have it. What?
That happens. I always feel like people want to watch me like a movie. It's nice to hear somebody say they want to read me like a book. What? What?
You deep and beautiful.
Get back. What are you doing?
Drinking.
Looks more like you're drowning.
Everything I am, everything I have. I didn't earn it. I don't deserve it.
I was just lucky.
And tomorrow, I might not be.
And that's life.
You're riding high in April, shot down in May.
You're quoting Frank Sinatra.
Yeah. He was an asshole. But yet he made millions of dollars, he had tons of adoring fans. You could be an asshole, or you could be a nice guy. It doesn't make a difference. It's all random. Luck of the draw.
Who knows if I'll make it?
You may make it to detox if you keep this up.
If life can be unfair, then I'm just gonna drink till I forget about life.
Beth, alcohol's a crutch. It may help you stand for a while, but it won't help you walk on your own.
If
eventually you're gonna have to face whatever it is that's bothering you.
So now I'm a bad person because not only have I not earned anything in life, but I also use a crutch to ignore that fact.
You're not a bad person because you use a crutch. Everybody does.
Not everybody drinks this much.
Well, there are a lot of different crutches besides alcohol. People use relationships, religion, caffeine, whatever. The main point is that everyone has their crutch.
Really? What's yours?
I don't know. That's the tricky thing about crutches. It could be right in front of your face. You can't even see it.
So are you a professor or what? No, senior. Eighth year. You're not graduating in 8 years. Well, I got 6 majors, but I can't seem to work that one phi ed class into my schedule.
Do you get tired of college?
I'm not here for college. I'm here for the beer.
I'll go get you something to eat.
Hey, Chris, where you been?
Watching the Warriors game.
Cool.
Why is Jeff taped to the wall?
That leech stole a mini keg and hid in the bathroom with it.
Really? Mm-hmm. Are you sure? I'm sure I saw somebody else going to the bathroom with it.
What? Are you trying to tell me that Jeff didn't take it?
I'm not sure, but I saw Fred with it.
I'm gonna go have a little talk with Fred.
Jeff seems to think that people get what they work for. And Erica thinks that God has a plan and a purpose for everything. But it still seems like they're ignoring a bunch of stuff.
Beliefs are personal. They don't necessarily hold in other people's lives.
But if they don't hold for anyone else's lives or for the world in general, aren't they basically useless? What is that smell?
I don't know. It smells like microwave puke in here. Let's get out of here, huh?
You know, Jeff and Erica's beliefs work just fine for them right now. But if they found themselves in a different situation, their beliefs might crumble.
That's probably true. Look at Erica, for instance. I mean, it's easy for Erica to think that God is looking out for her because she likes her life. But if she didn't like her life, she'd have to conclude that God hated her or would want the love of her life to get hit by a car.
Oh, but if her loved one dies, it's because God needed them in heaven. Like, God's all-powerful and can do anything, but he just needed that one extra person to play that game of pickup basketball.
Hey, if it explains your life, you go with it. Some beliefs are like crutches. They're just there to help you get through the day.
But eventually, isn't something gonna slap them back to reality?
It's tough to hit a turtle's head when it's hiding in the shell.
Sammy? Sammy? Sam? Hey, Frank! I need to talk to you about that mini can.
Please finish.
Rumor has it Jeff didn't take it. Now you will pay!
As time goes on, doesn't it get harder for people to keep their crutches?
Yeah, and you'll be weaker with them, too.
What do you mean?
Well, everyone has tough times in them, right? Rocky areas, mountains to climb up. And at first, our legs are weak and shaky. And so we grab crutches along the way to make things easier. But some of us get our crutches knocked away. We have to go along without them.
But won't people that have crutches have an easier time?
No, I don't.
For a while. But they won't grow stronger like the ones that stand and walk on their own. It may be tough going at first, but the uncrutched will stand tall and climb faster than the crutched.
So shouldn't we encourage everyone to get rid of their crutches?
In my experience, it's not always wise to knock someone's support from them. They have to be ready to stand on their own, and they just might not be.
How did we get on this topic anyway?
Oh, you were upset about the fairness of the world.
Right. Life's not fair, is it?
I don't know. One thing I have learned is that the more you blame the world for your fate, the worse they'll treat you. But the harder you work, the luckier you get. There's some sort of justice in there.
Hey, admit it. It was actually a little fun being taped to the wall, wasn't it?
Hey, fuck you, Orlando. Fred, you're a sick bastard. You can rationalize with your philosophy all you want, but it doesn't make what you do right.
Hey, everyone's justified. You and I are not as far apart as you like to think.
Yeah, we are. You're taped to the wall, and I'm walking out of here. Fuck, fuck.
Orlando.
What?
Hey, buddy. How about you let me down from this wall and everybody got a
shut up. You've been a bad dog, and you're gonna stay in this kennel for a long time.
I told him everybody's gotta have a hobby. And if the corrosion of your internal organs can't be one of them, then I want off this merry-go-round.
Hey, Bill! Give me some good luck.
Andy, are you drunk?
I don't think so. Oh, well, I'm still drunk. And I don't know what to think of what I'm thinking. I mean, it's so weird. I feel like I can talk to people and there's this connection there. I know I'm still drunk, but it seems so genuine. What is that?
I have no clue. Alcohol has a strange power.
Yeah. It's like a witch's brew that destroys the past and future, leaving only the now. And all you can do is sit back and go, yeah, this is pretty good. I'm pretty good. You are pretty good. What do you know? We're all pretty good together. No worries for this now. I feel like I'm a part of it. It's all flowing together into this loose groove. All is forgotten, and I feel it forever. Is that
No. It's too bad you have to be drunk to feel it, but at least you do.
Do you feel it?
Well, I don't drink, so I don't know if it's the same as drunk love. But I do feel love for everybody I've gotten to know.
Where does it come from for you?
I don't know. I guess as I've gotten to know people, I've come to a better understanding of them. And that understanding serves as sort of a common ground between us. And once I have that common ground, it's really easy for me to love someone.
Maybe. Maybe. That's why when I'm drunk, I feel such a connection. Alcohol serves as a common unifying ground between us.
It's shaky ground, but that might be it.
Shake, 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 shake.
I've been looking for this stuff all night.
You are not going to eat that.
You want the first bite?
God, no.
It's all true, man. It's not that bad. It's all fucking true, man. Come on, come on, come on.
God,
come on, come on, come on.
Oh, no. I know why you don't believe in love.
Oh, really? And why is that?
because you get dumped all the time.
But hey! Call 911. I'm gonna walk on your ass, baby.
Oh, yeah. Don't mess with Alaska.
What do you hear?
You have no heart.
What?
Come back to me.
Excuse me?
Come back to me.
Pete, don't do this to me. We're still going to be 1,000 miles apart.
Only for another semester. Once we graduate, we can try to get jobs in the same city. I think we're meant to be. Let's get back together.
Why do you want to get back together?
Because I love you.
Are you sure you're not just scared?
Are you calling me a fly?
No.
Because if I'm a fly, that means you're a piece of shit. And I know you're not a piece of shit.
I'm sorry. That came out wrong. I know you love me.
Okay, so maybe I am a little scared. My future looks shitty. I'll be in debt and jobless. But if I'm with you, I'll be happy. I think you would be too.
I would be. But I can't commit to a relationship when I don't know what my life is going to be like 3 months from now.
Eventually you're going to have to get over this fear of commitments you have.
Commitments are easy. Everybody has commitments. We did. It didn't last. I'm sorry, but I don't want to be your safety net. When we're together, we're together. But when we're not... We should really talk to them about
doing dishes. So I was wrong with my little theory.
No, you were right. I still love you. I never stopped. But just because two people love each other doesn't mean they should be in a relationship. It isn't that simple.
Who goes there?
It's me, Viv.
Oh, hey, sweetie pie. Come on in here.
Go away, ice queen.
You're a little emotional, aren't we?
So are you feeling any better?
Yeah, a little. Mary helped put things in perspective for me.
Good. I'm sure things will work out for you. Have faith.
I'd like to, but Faye seems so irrational.
Yeah. I mean, it is. What it comes down to for me is the question, do I live a happier life with or without Faye? The answer is with. I mean, it may be irrational, but a little hope never hurt anybody.
No? I suppose it doesn't. You should come to Mexico with Heather and me for spring break.
Oh, I'm gonna go on a Habitat for Humanity trip to Omaha.
But Mexico would be so much fun.
I don't have enough money.
You help others, but you can't give yourself a break?
Mary, I need you to hook me up.
Not now, Squeak.
Come on, just a little. Just need a little. I got $5.
Squeaks, not now.
What does he want you to sell him?
Some marijuana.
Squiggy.
Mary?
I can come back later if this is a bad time.
Yes, Squee. This is a bad time.
Okay, I'll come back later.
Much later.
Mary, I didn't know that you sold marijuana.
It's not something you advertise in the newspaper.
Mary, how could you? Of all the people I know, you're the last person I would expect to do something like sell drugs.
It's not like I'm selling crack. It's just a little pot.
It's still a drug.
Alcohol isn't?
Alcohol is legal.
But it's actually worse for you than marijuana. Listen, let me give you an example, okay?
Two people are playing a chess game and they get into an intense argument. Now, if they've been drinking all night, they pummel each other to death with the chess pieces. But if they'd been smoking marijuana, they would just sit and laugh at the pieces all night long. Now, which is worse?
I still don't understand how you can do it.
Do you think I sell for the fun of it? I sell because I have to. Do you remember the flood that hit Iowa 4 years ago? Well, it totally wiped out my family's farm and left us in a big financial debt. Now, I needed to come up with some big-time cash if I wanted to attend college. So my dad and I found a nice little patch of non-flooded farmland and started to grow marijuana. Now I sell it to help keep me in school.
I still think it's wrong. I think it's awesome. The media always portrays drug dealers as these lowlifes who beat up their girlfriends, and beat up their dogs, and beat up their girlfriends' dogs. I mean, Mary proves that not all drug dealers are scum and that women can deal drugs too. I mean, maybe America is finally the land of equal opportunity. And if a woman can be an astronaut or the president, she can deal drugs too.
Yeah, unfortunately, after dealing drugs, I won't be able to be president.
Well, you never know. And people might change their minds. I doubt it. You know, when you're selling marijuana, aren't you selling crutches?
Yeah, I guess I am. That's my crutch. Selling crutches and trying not to think about the consequences. But I'll be able to get rid of that crutch as soon as I'm out of med school.
Oh, well, what kind of a doctor are you going to be?
Oh, Mary wants to treat cancer patients.
In that case, you may never stop selling marijuana.
Hey, Erica. We say you make like Bob Martin's bullet shirt.
Shut up.
Come on. I'm wet. Now you're wet. What do you say you go back to my place and take off these wet clothes?
I'll leave you alone! Ah! Hey, stop that! Come on!
Is it okay to come out of the closet yet?
You can come out of the closet. It's okay to be gay. I knew it was an act all along.
Why don't you have a boyfriend?
You tell me.
You're really beautiful.
You're really drunk.
What does my blood alcohol level have to do with your looks?
Just tell me that when you're sober, okay?
Okay. You're great. And I'm not telling you that because I'm drunk. I'm telling you that because you are.
Louis, you don't have to say these things to make me feel better about myself.
What? What are you talking about?
I realized that you probably feel guilty for not being nice to me in the past, so now you're trying to make up for it. But I really wish you wouldn't. So next time when we talk and react differently, I won't feel hurt.
No. You don't understand. I've had a moment of clarity. When Clay stormed out and you said you just wanted someone to love, and there was that moment of silence, we connected. It was an intense bond. I've seen you. I understand, okay? I like you. I used to not like you, but I was blind. Now I see. I was Saul, now I'm Paul.
Please don't get biblical on me.
I just want you to understand that in my mind, you turn from water into wine, and I'm as drunk as a monk for you.
I shouldn't do this.
gonna hurt me so bad.
I'm not going to hurt you. And I'll tell you why. I feel something right now. I don't know what it is, but it is something. And it's for you. And I'm not going to question and attack it because it feels way too good. We've connected. And if I hurt you now, I would lose that. And I'm not going to let that happen.
Hi, sweetheart. How did we... Did we get in a fight?
Yeah.
And I don't like fighting.
Neither do I. You probably shouldn't drink so much.
I like drinking.
So do I, but we always end up hurting each other.
It's okay, love hurts.
Doesn't it bother you that we hurt each other?
Try not to let it.
Don't you love me?
Of course I do. In the good days. Honey? Honey? Hey, where are you going? What?
Hey, what's your problem?
I don't know, Clay. People have been telling me for ages now that I love you too much. I didn't believe them. You can't love a person too much. Well, maybe I was wrong. You know, I can't stay away from you no matter what we might do to each other. I can't not forgive you. I can't not understand you. I can't stop loving you. It's ironic. You don't have any control over your own life, but you have control over mine. And then you go and you say that you love me on the good days. Maybe you're right. Maybe I should only love you when it's convenient. Maybe it'll be good for me. In fact, I think I'll do that. And you know what? Today is not a good day and I do not love you. Who knows if tomorrow will be a good day or the day after that or next week or next month.
So you're saying we're through?
Half of me is screaming to say that. The other half is screaming against it.
Who's winning?
I am.
Hey, Danny boy, what do you got there?
Oh, leave me alone, man.
See, you're ready to come to college, huh?
Not if it's like this. guys are a bunch of freaks.
It's all the same. I think I'll just stay in high school.
You can judge college unless you have something to drink.
College is a fountain of knowledge, and the students come to drink.
Yeah, but why? I mean, on the surface, you're all having a good time, but, you know, at the same time, there's something that's all, I don't know, self-negating going on.
Check out the $5 word from Danny Boy. Self-negating? Try self-fulfilling. We're exploring other possibilities, other states, ourselves. Alcohol is an equal opportunity liberator. You can bring out the beauty or the beast in a person. To ignore half of its effects is naive and blind. It's more complex than that. It touches something that can either be described or denied.
I hear ya.
That's it. Everybody out! Out now!
Chill, Sam. Chill. We'll get you clean and all taken care of.
No, you won't. You'll get the hell out of my apartment is what you'll do. You'll quit sitting in my chairs. You'll quit drinking from my cups. You'll quit peeing on my toilet seat. You'll give me back my life.
You need to get a life. This is a party. People were invited here to have some fun. That is all we've been trying to do. You've been acting like it's a sin to let loose. Maybe if you had a drink sometime, you would learn how to enjoy yourself.
I know this is a hard concept for you to grasp, Orlando. But I don't need alcohol. I do enjoy myself. I like my friends. I like myself. I like my life.
Good for you, Sammy. Good for you. But I'm not gonna settle for your life. I'm trying to find something higher.
Fine. Just go conduct your crusade someplace else, okay?
You must have a nice life. A nice, quiet, suburban life. But tell me, when it's done, where would you have gone? Anywhere special? Or are you gonna die at sea level, not having climbed the mountains and touched the sky?
I had a splendid time. We simply must do this again.
Fuck you, Zed.
Marina? I owe you an apology.
For what?
Pressuring you about getting back together with
her. Oh, you don't have to apologize. I have to admit it was kind of hard for me to say no. I love our friendship, but I miss what we had in high school. Pete, I want to be together.
Then why aren't we?
You said it earlier. I'm in college. My priorities have to be a little screwed up. When I graduate, I'm going to be looking for a job, and I won't be able to decide what city I'll be in. Pete, I care about you more than a dumb job. But right now I have to make sacrifices. Hey, look up, little camper. No means no, but it doesn't mean never.
That's great, but what do I do in the meantime?
You enjoy the moment, seize the day. Carpe Reina.
Carpe Reina? I can't carpe Reina, she won't let me.
I never said that. You can seize the Reina. You just have to know when to let her go.
Oh, so it's a catch and release kind of thing?
I like to think of it more as you gotta make hay when the sun shines.
I'm just afraid the sun's never gonna shine again.
Pete, why do you think your future's gonna be so bad? You're smart, you're talented, you're good looking, you're great in bed. And everything's coming your way.
Except for you.
You never know. The world's a strange place and the dice are always rolling.
So, how are the dice treating me tonight?
Why don't you roll them and find out?
You sure you don't want me to walk you home?
Is the Pope Italian?
No, he's Polish.
Well, there's your answer.
Oh, gotta be the strong, independent woman, huh?
Well, I try.
Come on, you can't stay single your entire life. I mean, even the Lone Ranger had Tonto.
Yes, but I doubt the Lone Ranger and Tonto are lovers.
Never know. Clay! Buddy! How you doing?
Shitty.
Oh, that's too bad, because it's time to pay your dues.
Huh? Ooh! Come on, Sam, you're not really gonna make me go through with this, are you?
You see my sweater? That's puke. We had a deal, and now I'm gonna shave your ass.
But it's my ass. It'll hurt.
Tell you what. About a dozen things were broken at this party, and I could shave your head also. But I'll give you a choice. You can shave your head or your ass.
No, my do. Love my do.
But then you shouldn't have made the deal. Well now, what's it gonna be? Your head or your butt? Pride or pain?
Oh, God. I can't decide. Here. Flip a coin.
Clay, when are you going to take control of your life? Even now, you can't decide which part of your body to shave. You hand your fate over to a coin.
Well, what's it to you?
You're my friend. I care about you. I wish you did, too. You could change your life, but instead you allow yourself to be consumed.
Give me a break. I'm only human.
Yeah, you are. Okay, let's get this over with. Heads, your head. Tails, your tail. And may fate have mercy on your ass.
Don't kiss and don't tell. You gonna get yourself in trouble. Your true love will leave you. You're different, that's why she said so long. Sweetest little songbird, the sweet song of mine.
Look, I says to him, I don't take my clothes off for any prof, okay? Jeez, I'm getting that shit.
So, how about this party, man? It's a weird party. It's a weird life. Yeah. Life, man. Life is like a trip, man. Life's a trip. It's like one of those long road trips, and you're just sitting there driving along in your car, and like all these people, they're only like 5 feet away from you, but you never talk to them, you never even look at them, and you know, you're just driving along and just hoping you can make it to the next bathroom because you gotta pee really bad. And you know, it's like you make it to the bathroom, and then so what do? You go buy a big gulp when you're done because you don't care that you're gonna have to go to the bathroom and get another half hour. And the bathroom, it was all important to you, but you're in your car, you're driving away, you don't even care anymore. You look up in your rearview mirror, it's a little bit smaller, and you keep driving along, you look up again, it's a little bit smaller still, and you know, you look up one day and it's gone. And it looks like it's just this highway that stretches on forever. There's nothing back there, man. There might have never been anything back there. Yeah, man. Life's a trip. Aren't you been smoking? Existentialist dilemma lights?
What the hell are those?
I don't know. Clay put him on. He's the pervert.
So you guys sleep together tonight or what, huh?
Hey, Mary. This is Sammy. You know, my glaucoma is acting up, and I was wondering if, Yeah, the usual. Uh-huh. Okay, and that'll come in brown paper bag? Okay, thanks. Talk to you later. Bye.
He's gonna do it?
Of course.
All right, man. Thanks. Cool.
That actually feels pretty good.